at High Street Kensington Tube Station, except I'm not about to get a tube train. I'm about to get a bus with the help of this man. This is Hugo.
Hi, Hugo.
Hi.
Hugo has appeared in one of my videos before when we did a video about how many buses could you do on a bus hopper.
It's already, we've had three in quick succession, we're number four.
How many minutes in are we? You know what the time is? We've been going for 10 minutes.
So 24 buses?
So we're on target for 24 buses at the moment.
Since that, there's been many conversations about what's the furthest you could go on a bus hopper. Could you get to Heathrow Airport using bus hopper for just £1.50, right?
Yes.
And you think it's possible?
Yes.
If you travel from central London, which we're going to take to mean zone one, to Heathrow Airport, if you get the Heathrow Express, it'll cost you like £22.
Yes.
If you go TfL Rail from Paddington, it's like £10.10. If you get the Piccadilly line, it's still like £3. But you think that by using the bus hopper, we can get from zone one, which is here, High Street Ken, to Hatton Cross Heathrow for just £1.50.
In the daytime.
So the moment that you saw me touch my Oyster card,
you I ducked the stopwatch.
You hit the stopwatch. So now, which way are we going? If you look on, like, say, Journey Planner or on City Mapper, it recommends to get a bus from HSK to Heathrow to go down to Hammersmith, then pick up. And the logical route is to get the H91. And then later on, which takes you to Hounslow West, and then head for Heathrow. But Hugo thinks he knows better. Hugo, could you explain why that won't work?
Because the thing about the hopper is the last journey you make, you can spend as long on it as you like, but you have to get to that last point within the 70-minute time limit.
So you mentioned a great thing there. So the hopper, as many buses as you like within 60 minutes, is actually secretly, well, not so secretly because we're telling you, it's actually 70 minutes. So as long as we make our last change, as long as we're on the bus to take us to Heathrow before 70 minutes, and you looked it up, and if we took the H91, we wouldn't get to Hounslow West within 70 minutes.
It's a lovely 74.
So instead, Hugo, what are we going to do?
We are off to Hammersmith, and then we're going to get a bus to Richmond, which we can probably get to within 50-60 minutes. 190 or 419, and then from Richmond we can get the 490, which will take us to Heathrow, and that'll get us there in time.
So here's the plan with the map. The most direct way is to take any bus to Hammersmith, at which point you catch the H91 to Hounslow West. But remember, we've got to be there in under 70 minutes to catch any bus to Heathrow to stay within the 70 minutes bus hopper time limit, and it's not possible, we don't think, to make it in time. So instead, at Hammersmith, we'll take either one of two buses down to Richmond, which we'll make in around 50 minutes, and that gives us 20 minutes spare to catch the 490 all the way to Heathrow. Easy, right? When we get to Hammersmith?
Let's go and get the 419 to Richmond.
Why is that? Why that one?
Why that one? Because then we can go between the bus stations.
So we just passed Olympia, the station. The exhibition hall is there. Remember, the whole key to this is can we get on to the bus at Richmond in under 70 minutes? Yeah. But first, we have to change at Hammersmith. And we're heading to get which bus number, Hugo?
419.
The 419. Did you see one as we came in, or was...
I did not.
So we're at bus stop L. Is it bus stop or bus stand?
I'm going with bus stop.
I'll go with stop. Oh dear.
How long?
Oh, Hugo.
Oh God.
17 minutes.
What about the 190?
Well, what about the 190?
Unfortunately, we've gone down to the bottom and we might have to go back up to the top again.
There's one in 3 minutes. There's a 190 in 3 minutes.
Well, back up.
Go, go, go!
419's usually better because it doesn't have the traffic.
190.
And there is a 190 due in 2 minutes. We are on the 190. I don't think I've ever been on the 190 before.
Well, I have.
give me an amazing fact about the 190, Hugo.
It's the only bus to go over Chiswick Bridge.
Okay, there we go. Amazing fact. Learned.
We'll be doing now.
Okay, here's a shot of us crotching, what? Crossing. Chiswick Bridge. We're about 5 minutes out from Richmond. We're 48 minutes in. However, Hugo, I have to inform you, we've just missed a 490 from outside Richmond Station. Are they every 10 minutes or are they every half an hour?
15, I think.
Oh, man. Okay, we might make it.
We might.
It's gone from... I've gone from being confident that this was going to be easy to we might make it. But this traffic's quite bad, Hugo. Do we get out and walk, or do we stay on the bus?
That's a good question.
We've done something rather controversial. The traffic is so bad, and we haven't even got to the roundabout. We think we can beat the bus, which is there, by walking. So we're going to walk the last bit down to Richmond Station. Yeah, this traffic is busy. We've made the right choice to walk. Our bus is not the one in the foreground you can see, it's the one in the background you can't see. We are beating the bus.
By walking.
But we've got about 15 minutes, because the clock's on 55 minutes, to tap in on a 490. And if there is no 490, we don't make it. Do we even bother going to Heathrow if we don't make it? Because we've then failed. Ah. But the good news is this is the roundabout, and the bus stop.
It's past the roundabout.
It's just past the roundabout. We're at Richmond Station. Bus stop E is here. But look, it's saying how often?
Every 12 to 13 minutes.
So it can't be every half an hour. Here's my theory. What if there's one due, but the driver just hasn't logged into iBus?
That's possible.
Correct me if I'm wrong. So when the drivers get to their stand or they're starting a new journey, they log into iBus,
yeah.
And that then sets up the next journey. So if he just hasn't done it yet, it won't be appearing in the data feeds, which then come up on the apps. So a 490 and advertised on the app could roll in any second.
Yes.
So we just need a 490 to roll up. Let's look at the stopwatch.
That's our 190.
So we beat our 190. Hang on, what's this? No, there's a 493. It's a 493. My clock is saying we've just done an hour. We've literally done the hour. So if a 490 turns up in the next nine minutes,
we'll have made it.
If it doesn't, then fail. It's saying 16 minutes. The app is saying the next one is 16 minutes and we only have 8 minutes. We need the app.
To be wrong. I don't think we've made it. I think we haven't made it because there's a gap in the service. There was no 490 where there was meant to be a 490. We've missed it. We haven't made it.
Sadly, when this clock's over to 1:10, we haven't made it. And the next 490 is about 6 minutes away. Looking at the bus feed apps as we came down, approaching Richmond, we just missed one, which means there was a gap. There's been a gap of around half an hour between 490s. And the timetable there is very clearly saying every 12 to 13 minutes. So there's been a bus missing. So in 8 seconds time, we're about to fail to do it.
Four, three, two, one.
We have not made Zone 1 to Heathrow for £1.50 on this occasion. starting to worry if 490s actually exist. Are you sure they're a thing?
I think we saw one going the other way.
Okay.
Maybe they only go on one though.
Okay. we're still here waiting for the magic 490 not to appear. Any second now. Right?
Hugo, look!
A 490?
It's happened! It exists! It exists!
We have managed to get on
a 490.
Show them my stopwatch. So 1 hour
30 minutes 48 seconds.
So about 20 minutes over the 70 minutes for the hopper.
Yeah. But we have been waiting here.
We did wait at Richmond for a good half an hour.
More than half an hour.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go one stop. And then walk back to Richmond.
And then go home.
And then we'll go home. Thanks, 490.
Thank you finally coming.
For our one stop on the 490.
It exists.
Yeah. The 490 bus does exist. But I think we need to debrief. We need to get a cup of tea. And we'll go sit on the train, right?
Yes.
Let's do that.
I do take trains.
That's the end of our day. We're on the train home. Hugo, how's your day? Sum up the
highs and lows. That'd probably be it.
The point is it possible to do? And I think the answer is yes.
Definitely possible.
Did we manage to do it today? The answer is no.
No, we didn't.
Do you, at Hammersmith, should we have waited for that first bus? Or was it good that we switched? Where did we go wrong?
We went wrong by just being unlucky, I suppose.
So, what I sense we've inadvertently done now to YouTube is thrown down the gauntlet. Can you, out there, anyone, do what we failed to do today? So you've got to go to High Street Ken, or any Zone 1 station, and you've got to get to Hatton Cross Heathrow, all for £1.50. But you've got to make that last connection before your 70 minutes is up, is that right?
That's correct.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Thanks very much.
You too.
It's gone very quiet over there.
It has, hasn't it?
Yeah, wow.
And TfL, please, put more 490s on at Richmond, because that was a shame.
Tell us they exist.
Thanks, Hugo.
Thanks.
Cheers.